who's so dope. I get the munchies just thinking about it. Give it up for the brilliant Will. I am. Got your man bag. What's in your man bag?
It's a backpack.
A backpack?
Yeah, it's my bag. Yeah.
You've got a backpack and a camera.
Phone. Camera phone.
Camera phone?
Yeah, this is a. I call it IM Plus.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you can take a. Of course, you take pictures with it. But what's cool and fresh and hip about it is. So.
No, let me. Because I have trouble with turkey neck. Catch me off guard. So where's that photo going now, then?
Oh, I didn't post it.
Yeah, don't put it on any dodgy websites. Anyway, let's have a drink. What would you like, love? I've got Sonatogen. This schlurp.
It's called schlur?
Yeah.
As if, like, you drink it and you start slurring your words?
Yeah, but it's non-alcoholic. But do you want a bit of schlur? It's non-alcoholic. You can drive and everything and operate machinery.
OK.
Well, welcome back to the UK. Now, you recently became the first man ever to perform your music, well, to have your music played from Mars. How amazing is that? Would you ever do a gig on another planet? Now, that would be cool, wouldn't it? Seriously?
I know where you're gonna go with this.
What?
You're gonna say, would you do a gig on Uranus? I knew that was coming.
As if I'm gonna say that. Scroll along on the auto cue. That's what. So what was it like then playing back? Could you imagine someone your song coming from Mars?
So first, last year I was in NASA. It's a big round room, and I'm there, and I'm pitching idea on how to get kids excited about STEM to all these NASA people. So then I was there. I got an idea. How about when you launch that rocket to Mars, a rocket lands, a rover lands, then it beams back a song and you broadcast it to all the channels online to inspire these kids, because if you didn't do that, they probably would never know that a rocket's been to Mars.
Because you know Cheryl, she says the reason you had that car crash was you were too busy talking about NASA and your eyes weren't on the road.
So we were driving and we was in the studio. It was the same day. So it came from NASA maybe a couple of hours before the accident. And so she was like, so where's Mars? I'm like, you know, it's right over there. You see that orange star? Going boom.
Oh, no. Poor old Cheryl. Did she get confused with Mars? No, because she gets confused in the science bit of the shampoo advert. You know, she goes, I'm worth it. You've come from the future, yeah? I do. You have come from the future. So what's everyone going to be doing on their mobile phones in the future? Go on, give it, because you can see. Say it's 2050, what we're going to be like.
In 2050, there probably won't be phones.
Oh, what will there be?
So in the future, we'll have, like, glasses like these. Yeah. And there'll be computers. And you'll have, like, a digital aura or a digital halo of all your social media content, and you program it.
In my eyes?
No, no, no.
That would be like...
I need to do a tweet. That's gonna get me into trouble.
No, no, no. So imagine, like, right here...
I'm sending a fax.
You know, like... You'll have, like, little cameras right here.
Oh, yeah,
looking out.
Oh, I love it.
And then you'll have, like, this display on your glasses. And then it'll be the first time a person who's speaking in sign, and your ears will go around in your ear, right? The thing will go like that.
Yeah.
Then a person will be speaking in sign, and then your glasses will translate it, and actually, the first time you'll hear sign. Booyah, that'd be dope.
Booyah. Oh. my thing about iPhones and all that, yeah, you've got all these amazing apps. You can book train tickets, plane tickets, send photos everywhere. Spill a cup of tea over it, it's like... Why don't you... Exactly. Why don't you create something that's waterproof? I put a condom over mine. Safe sex.
Condom?
A sheath. At least if you get a ribbed one, it's nice just to put it in your pocket and go for a jog.
Don't sit on it. No, I'm joking. That's bad.
Now, you've recently been working on a new track with Britney Spears, Scream and Shout. And what's she like?
Britney's fresh. She's like, she loves music just as much as I do. Going in the studio with her is like, it's like glue.
Yeah.
Like, what I mean by that is like we're just stuck to music and trying to fine-tune it and whatnot. So I had fun working with her on the video as well.
This is out today, isn't it?
Boom, yeah.
So this is a Chatty Man exclusive.
This is a Chatty Man exclusive.
That's an edit, I do my own edits.
Yeah, I know, I saw that. Why does Britney keep calling herself bitch?
No. She's not calling herself bitch.
Oh.
It's Britney, bitch.
Hey, I thought it was a bit like self-loathing going on or something.
No, it's like...
Like Alan twat. And you've got a recording studio in your house, and is it true the place is haunted?
Yes.
Oh, my God. But by a horny ghost.
No, there was this one time when I was sleeping and... The blankets came off me. It's one thing to haunt me and be like, boo, shit like that, right? Yeah. but rip the blankets off me.
Yeah. Oh, my God. How do you know it wasn't Britney with a sheet over it? It's Britney, bitch.
So that was kind of spooky, though. That,
yeah.
So that's, but the house has nice energy. I wrote a lot of good songs there, and if it was a bad energy,
I
probably wouldn't have gotten good vibes from that house.
No. You're back on The Voice next year.
Yeah, I can't. We start
love The Voice. I heard no one was doing it. Then you're all doing it. What changed?
I think people were just worried about who was going to come on or not. There was going to be a new cast.
Yeah.
And that's uncomfortable because we all gelled.
Yeah, yeah, so you're all great together.
I think we all wanted to know if everybody was really going to come on. Mm. You know, I can't see myself doing it without the three.
And you know Jessie J is shaving her hair off, you know that.
I'm shaving my hair off too.
Really?
Not up here. Right here.
I've got to see that, you turning around like that. Hi, this is dope. No, I mean, you're right.
I'm wearing tank tops and I'm going to be throwing my hands up.
Yeah.
And you don't want woofy.
No way. What about dope? Because you know Nicole is on the X Factor. She's going, two words, honey, shamazing.
She said that?
I mean, dope ain't dope anymore. You need to come up with a new catchphrase. Because that's why we loved you. You always had like a dope, super dope.
I didn't think about, because that's how I am at home.
All right.
Thanksgiving was great this year. You know, my mom made this dope pie. And she was like, Willie, what'd you think about that pie? Yeah. Ma, this is dope. That's how my family is, you know? It's pretty.
So it's not actually a catchphrase. You say dope all the time.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm glad to hear it. when Jessie J was here, I dared her. The first time, you know, those chairs rotate, she's going to stick her tongue out. Like that, yeah? And I've got to think of a dare for you the first time it turns round the chair. You do the comedy glasses. That's hysterical. You should do that. Can you do that for me?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, take one last picture of me. Holding my schlur. This isn't awkward. Oh, you... Oh, no, that's right. Oh, that's horrible! That's horrible! Oh, good luck with your single and your camera thing. It is always fun, isn't it, having will.i.am on the show? You're always welcome here. Thank you so much. After the break, Michael McIntyre and Keith Lemon will be here. See you in part two.